Last time I discussed about the female infertility. Today I'm going to discuss a little about male infertility. Now, male infertility is about 40% is seen in about 40% couples or infertile couples, in about 40% infertile couples, and it is about 7% of the entire male population in the world is infertile. Now, it is therefore quite common. And how do we know male infertility? How do we come to know about it? The only way to know about male infertility is when we do semen analysis. Semen analysis is done specially, preferably after 4 days of abstinence, and then the semen is drawn, where the masturbated sample is the best, and within half an hour we have to process it. Now, what are the common causes of male infertility? It can be divided into 3 or 4 different types of causes. One is the ejaculatory dysfunction, then there is poor production of the semen, then there is low production of the semen, faulty production of the semen, the quality is not good, and lastly there can be blockage, which doesn't allow the semen to come out, the sperms to come out in the ejaculate. The ejaculatory dysfunction is commonly seen nowadays in couples or in the males who are generally extremely psychologically stressed out. There's interpersonal relationship problems, and this is becoming more common these days. Ejaculatory dysfunction also does not allow the couple to have a normal relationship. It's premature ejaculation sometimes, the difficulty in ejaculation. And we see that these couples generally need counseling or psychotherapy or maybe de-stressing, different mechanisms to de-stress. The other common causes where there is low sperm function, the low sperm production, or functionally the sperms are not very good quality wise. The commonest causes there are infections, then there can be a condition where there is excess blood flow to the testes, we call varicocele. This is a condition which can be treated definitely by surgery. Then there are tumors of the testes. Then there can be even other conditions in the, like excess tobacco chewing, where people are now smoking and chewing tobacco a lot, the males, we see that. Excess alcohol consumption, then obesity. Obesity also contributes to poor sperm production. Other important causes for low sperm production and faulty sperm production is when infections are there, like gonorrhea, syphilis, HIV, which is also quite, it's seen significant cases. Certain other conditions where they are exposed to chemicals, pesticides and these other harmful chemicals, even radiations. Certain other cases where the couple, even the cases where the male is more subjected more to where he's doing an, there's no exercise, and the scrotum is, since there is, we say the production of heat is more in that region, which happens generally when there are sedentary jobs. Like we see nowadays, most of the men are in IT professions and they have to sit a long time with the laptops, or they have no exercise which they are doing. So in that case, the scrotum becomes, generally even the driving, if you're driving for a long time in the car, then we see that the scrotal region, the testes become little more heated than normal. And in that case also spermatogenesis is affected. Spermatogenesis is the production of sperms which gets affected. So we do see that in those cases also the semen becomes compromised. The blockages we see commonly in infections. Infections which I told you already, like syphilis, gonorrhea and all, do cause blockages in the tubes which transmit the sperms to the ejaculate, to the penis. And we do see that there the semen and the sperm count becomes very low, or there is poor sperm production. If the testes in childhood do not come down to the scrotum, then we call them undescended testes. And in these testes also we see that the sperm production is very poor, and the semen analysis shows the sperm is faulty, sperm count is low. Hormones, the male hormone is the testosterone. Now, if testosterone is low in the body, again in the male, we see that semen production is not, the sperm production is poor. Now, how do we also know? Through the blood test, the testosterone levels are known, and also certain characteristics, like if there are excess breast product, breasts are enlarged, if the hair are very scanty in the male, in that event also we suspect testosterone deficiency. So we have tackled a few of the important causes of male infertility, and the next session I would like to go into the examination of the semen and the parameters, how we judge how the semen quality is poor, and what is the treatment for all this, and how do we go about treating these patients. So next session I will tackle the treatment and the management of male infertility. Thank you very much.